Speedflow Basics. Speedflow Basics is a series of videos that will teach you how to use Speedflow. In this video, we'll use the techniques learned previously to make a foot pump. So, let's start. As you can see, I'm using the metric system in centimeters for the length. I will create a simple plane. I will go and edit the settings. Here. The dimension. I will want to this 18 in X and 26 in Y. As you can see, the scale isn't applied, so I will press Ctrl A, apply scale, and that's it. Now it's correct. What I will do is to add, in fact, a mirror. I will activate the bisect, Shift X, like that. And if we check, if I hide this and this, and if we check for the wireframe, now I have this. So that's mean. If I select this one and press bevel, like that, I will just play with the profile, boom. I will move it before here, the mirror, with the upper OK. I will have this kind of result. So I just have to play on the on only one part, and as you can see, if I go on this part, that will merge the point. So this is interesting because you can play with the profile just like that and have exactly what you want. Press tab, select this one, space, bevel. So just like that, do the same. You need to move it before the mirror X and you will have the result you want. So let's make it bigger, just like that. Let's play with the profile. I don't want to do exactly the same, so I will try to make something different. Let's play with the profile here. So it's almost the same, but not the same. So now I will press space and I will add a solidify. With the solidify, I will press D to change the offset. I will put the offset to 1. I can press Enter 1, just like that. And as you can see, I have this result. So play with the thickness. Now I will come back on the bevel and I will press Shift Space here to add a new bevel, just like that. I will just hide this one to show you. So this is our result so far. As you can see, we have something weird here. I think it's because on the last bevel I need to activate the loop slide, G. As you can see, that will fix it. So this is perfect. Now go in top view. As you can see here, the bevel needs more work. This is the second one. I will play with the profile, just like that. Increase the number of segments, and that should do the work. Maybe a little more. So bevel, select the second one, F profile. Or let's see if I decrease the size and play with the profile now. Yes, this is better. So I will cut a part here. I will call cutter. I will press Ctrl to create a line. And I will click, that will give me this result. Shift to constrain on one axis. Click. Do something like that. Shift. Shift. Like that. Shift. And shift. So, I can press Ctrl to have something perfect. And space, that will create this. Okay? I can after play with the profile. So, can decrease it if I want. What I will do is to edit this object. I want something a little bit different. I will press G, like that. I want something here, and maybe, in fact, all of this more, like that. And I want this boolean. In fact, I want to move my mirror up after everything. So like that, if I make something here, that will come here. So let's continue. I will select this one, I will take this vertice and I will add a bevel. So just like that, as you can see, I can play with the profile, play with the number of segments, make something that will work like that. And after I can just edit it a little to make it better, hop, to find something that will work correctly. Hop, let's see. Like that. Press F. Pop-pum. D. Yup. Let's make it like that. Okay. You can do the same with the other ones. That means I can add on this one if I want to make something bigger. and I will keep the other like that. So, seems correct, maybe select, in fact, I will select all of this with B, and I will move it like that, and maybe select all of this with B, and move it a little like that. Okay, so, we made this, that seems correct, yes, I like it like that. I will keep it like that. So, I can now hide this one, press H, and maybe play, no, I will keep it like that. So, sorry. I will use the cutter, I will click here and here, I will press space. That will give me this kind of result. I will press tab, and I can press S to scale it, G to move it, and let's see, G to move it here. I will select those two and press space and bevel, and I will add a bevel just like that. So maybe I will press solidify S to have something that will work better. Okay? After you can press with D, etc., etc., but you want to have something correct here. That's it. I will press H to hide this one. What you can do now is to save your scene. Save. I will come back in my speed for basics. Let's see the 8. Yes. So, I will name it Speedflow Basics 08. Yep, the other one. Enter and save it. So that's it. Let's continue. What I will do is duplicate this one because I'm a lazy guy. I will press Shift D. I will remove the mirror, control click. I will go in edit mode, in fact no, in object mode I will remove the bevel, control click. I will go in edit mode, I will select everything, I can activate this, and I will just move this one here. Like that. I will select all of this, and I will move it like that. Up. And this, and move it like that. Okay, should be correct like that. What I can do is to add a small bevel. Can place. I like to have four segments. I think it's nice because you have something really clean like that. What I will do now is to have my selection, this one, and I will press Shift Q and Shift to place a cube on this one. I will move it here. I will go in edit mode, scale it a little. Just like that, just like that, just like that. I will select this one, I will press space and bevel, just like that. And I will press space, array, and I will click on C to create a circular array. So in fact, I can do something like that. Normally, there is only four, but maybe why not add more? Could be interesting to have more. And I will play with the displace, and I will just decrease it like that. Okay, so I will go in edit mode, select everything, I will edit it a little. And as you can see, I do it in edit mode because I want it to work correctly to have the profile to one. And I will make, let's see, something like that. Okay, let's see, up. Just select this one, up. Move it a little. You can do this if you want to see if it's correct, if it's placed inside the other one. So, just like that, I will select this one, and I will make a boolean. I will choose union, and I will have this kind of result. So sometimes you will have this. So what I can try to do is to play with this screw. And as you can see, I need a correct number to have something that will work. And this is perfect. Okay, so if I press 6, I can see, I can test. It seems the bevel is a little bit too strong. Let's try to make it like that. Should be better. So just like that, I created this. Okay, so this is interesting. And if I don't like that, I can select this one, play with the array, and decrease to make, let's see, like it is normally. I will keep it like that. Let's follow the original. Okay, seems correct. Let's hide this one and hide this one. What you can do now is to save, because this one was, I think, a little bit complicated. Plus, save. So the next part will be a little bit more complicated. That means I want to make something on this one, but first I need to edit it a little. Let's move this one here. Okay, because I want something here. What I will do is maybe make it here, and after I will be able to place it here. So, or maybe place the cursor directly here. The thing is that that will be difficult to place the cursor here because, as you can see, this one is an object, is a mirror. So placing the cursor directly like that with Shift RMB, as you can see, this is not this is not really correct. So maybe what I can do is to create. Let's see. I can create. Let's see this. Up, and I will just move this one. Boom, come here. Maybe there is a better solution, but just at this time I don't think find anyone. So let's go in top view. Up, like that. Up, like that. Okay. So I can press Shift S, cursor to selected, and I can remove this one. So just like that, I created it. So. What I want is to add a part inside of this one. That means I will press Shift Q. I will add a screw primitive. Let's move it. Let's see here. I will go. In fact, I will press. Let me think how I will do it. I will press G. I will disable this. Bam bam. Let's press G. Let's move it vertically. Press E to make this. I can add a solidify, play with the offset to have this kind of result. Okay. So now I will add, let's see, a plane. Shift space. On this plane, I will scale it. I will add a bevel. Boom, bevel. I will just choose two segments and profile to -1. And like that, I will be able to make this. Okay, so this is correct too. I will move this one, let's see here, and I will add a solidify. Just like that. And in fact, I can use it like that. Could be nice too. So just decrease it. And I think I will use it like that. I like it like that. And in fact, this is way simpler than the test I made. So let's add, let's see, another screw primitive. So this one, youpla, go here, is like that, so I will just move it here, and just select the bottom part, and let's see, I will move it like that, to have something like that. I can, in fact, on this one, press Alt-D, like that, boom, and Alt-D, and why not move this, press G, like that. Okay, I will just move this one and snap it, and after I will be able to move this one like that. If you want, you can select this one, Alt-D, up, Alt-D, and just move those two like that to make something like that. So this is not too bad, maybe, hopla, move this one here to have this result. So, let's increase the number of segments, and I need, let's see, 48. But 48 will not be perfect, as you can see. If I add a bevel here, that will not give me the result I want. So let's use this one, maybe. It's not perfect, I don't like to see this, but we have some limitation with Blender, sadly. On this one, I think I will just, let's see, move it a little like that. And maybe, in fact, move this one like that. Okay. Seems correct. I will select this one, Boolean S. That will give me this result. This one, Boolean S. That will give me this result. This is normal because I don't have a bevel now. I will just now add a bevel. And boom, that will give me the result with my bevel. As you can see, I need to edit it a little. That means I need, hopla, I will exit to select the other object. The wireframe, can I select the other plane? No, this is not this one. This one is correct. The plane, where is the plane? As you can see here, yes, this one. I will go in edit mode, I will scale it a little, just like that. I will play with the bevel, just like that. Press, I think it's 4, yes. Play with the bevel and try to find and to have the result you can want and that will not break. This one seems to be not too bad. And what I will do is, in fact, this one, I will play with this solidify. Up, I cannot, it's not this solidify. It's in edit mode. This one, I will just move it a little. And that's it. So just like that, I created this. Maybe the bevel is too big. Let's decrease it a little. Like that. So, if you click here, you will see your result. So for me, this is correct. What I will do is to parent the object. In fact, you can do it automatically with SpeedFlow. It's in the add-on preferences. And I will parent all of this. Parent, just like that. So just like that, if I move this one, everything will follow. Because this one is at the bottom here. Just like that, as you can see. Maybe move it a little here. So now I will add a piece here because there is something at the bottom and I can just, yes, I can just call the cutter, Alt to create a new object and Shift and Alt to create a new object. Ah yes, the origin, the cutter is not placed correctly, but it's not really an issue. I will press this and let's see, I will choose the Y to make a rotation on the solidify on the Y axis. I can after play with this and play with the solidify, add a little bevel and just move this one. So this one was a little bit too fast, so I will show you again. So as you can see, I created something that will close this one, okay? Because that the air will come here and will exit here. So I need to make it work and it's like that on my own pump. So what I wanted to show you is that, let's see, I will place my cursor here, I will just align the rotation of the cursor, clear rotation. With cutter, you will press Alt to create a new object, and you will press Shift and Alt to create a cylinder on the cursor, just like that. That will give you this result, after space and after bevel. As simple as that, and this is pretty fast. So now let's hide all of this. Boom. And we created this part. So as you can see, it was pretty fast, I think. And you can be faster, of course. And the result seems to be correct. Maybe increase the bevel of this one finally. Up. Not too small, but not too big. Could be nice to try to play with this screw to see if I can yes, that maybe can work with this. Let's see, I will do this. Up, like that. So, boom boom. Let's increase it. Just try, planet you, 6. Check if you seems to have a little issue. Seems to be correct on this one. Here I need to add some loops. Let's see if I decrease. No, that will not change anything. So let's press 6, 86, it was okay. So on the bool object, in fact, I will just have to come here. I will not see it in this, yes, now I can see it. Sadly, we cannot see it in the other mode. So as you can see, on this one, I need to edit it a little. That means this one needs to be in the bigger. And what I wanted is to add some loops. So let's select those two. Boom. And it was to select this one, this, and add maybe 60. Up. Yes. If you don't have any artifact, it should be correct almost. Up. Let's see. This one seems to be. No. Up. And this one, I think I will have to decrease it a little, sadly. Yes, like that. What I can do is to select vertices. So I need press 1, press 3, where are my vertices? Select everything. I will press Alt D and move this here. And tab 3, click, and that's it. Not perfect, but you will never see anything up there. With the distance we will be. So as you can see, in this distance, even here, you can't see anything. So this part is correct. File, save as, plus save. Let's continue. So now I have some possibilities. I will duplicate this object. Boom. Let's rename it bottom. Up. Like that. And the other one, this one, top. Like that. I can hide the bottom. And in fact, I don't need this. I will select all of this. That means press B, select this, press M, create a new collection. I will name it top. Like that. Press OK. And I can normally, hop, hide top. If I show the bottom, I will have this result. So, on the bottom, I don't want all of this, so I will remove all the modifiers. You can use SpeedFlow, but it will be better to easier to use this, or if you want to work in full screen, you can use this. So, like that, I will remove the booleans. Like that. Okay. So, in fact, I can even duplicate this one. Yes, I will duplicate it. I will remove the last boolean, I will remove the bevel, I will remove the, I will keep the mirror. I will select everything, hop, I will scale it a little, and let's move it here. I want something different from the bottom, and maybe play with the bevel, the profile on this one. And on the other one, select the other one, yes, this one. F, like that, play, maybe, plat. So, this is not really clean here, but you will see after. So, number of segments, like that, profile, like that, up, and try to have something that will work. Yes, seems correct. I will just move this one here, and now, just move it again, I will make a boolean. And I will have my result. So, maybe move it here. Yes, it's interesting. I will keep it like that because this is the bottom and should be enough. Okay. So this is how bottom and this is the top. What I want to do is, in fact, to add a collection instance of the top, just like that. I will press Alt G. And like that, I will be able to move it because this is a collection. And I will keep my top directly at the center. That means it will still be here. So when I want to finish it, I will have it flat. So like that, I will be able to make it correct and to finish it correctly. So just like that, I will take this one. I will make a rotation. Just like that. Up. And I will move it. Let's see. It's bigger. It's more like that. Let's try to keep something like that. So let's move it in the local global mode, like that. So now we will have something here and something here. Ah, as you can see, I forgot something. That means I wanted to have a part here and a part here. But since I forgot to add it, and since I'm using the instance collection, if I work on the top here, I will be able to add it after. So that means let's hide the bottom, like that. Like I said, I will duplicate this one, like previously, Shift D. I will just move it, and as you can see, that will follow the other one, okay? So on this one, I will remove all the booleans. And yes, every booleans, just like that. I will select everything, I will make a little scale. I want it to be, let's see, yes, scale it a little like that, move it a little like that. So control 7 to be sure to have something correct. Just move it here. Try to have something like that. It's nice. Okay. So we made this. I can play with this solidify like that. Let's see. And make it bigger. And make it vertically like that. Up. Should work. So normally this one, I just have to remove this one. X only faces. Yes, I'm lucky. I can in fact select everything, but I will use on this one the screw. I will press G0 and I will press D just like that. I will remove the number of segments. I'm using this because I don't want to break the bevel, because I'm using the vertex group, so that will break it if I do it. And I can play with the number of segments on this one, and with this I can play with this. So let's move it here. I can press 7 to check if it's rotated on the normals. I can remove it with R 7, add a solidify. I already have a solidify. So yes, I need to move it after this one. Boom. Like that. Should be enough. One thing I can do is to move the mirror after everything to have something that will work correctly. And as you can see, I need to edit the bevel. So not this one, because this one is the bevel angle. This one I need to move it after. Play with the width, just like that. I need to edit those two. So the first one is this one. I need to make something perfect. So let's edit it a little like that. Yes, correct. And on this one, apply again a little. Yes, seems to work. So that's it. As you can see, since this object is in this collection, if I move it, I edit it here, this object, since this is the instance, will follow, and I will have exactly the result I want. If you want, in fact, you can play with this screw to invert it. Up, let's check this, it's correct. And to move this one here. So like that, I will be able to play with this if I want first to add some segments, like that, and after to change the size of this. So this is nice. So let's maybe play with it a little. Yes, should be correct. I will duplicate this one, Shift D, just like that, and I will remove it from this collection. So this one, I will come back and move it here. So let's hide the top, let's show the bottom, and let's move this one from the bottom. I could even add, make it an instance to have exactly the same, but I will keep it like that. Now we will save our scene. File, save as, plus save. So as you can see, with SpeedFlow I can do all of this. It's pretty easy to deal with, and we have something perfect. And this is the most important part for me. Keeping everything editable and having a perfect result. What I will do now, in fact, is to gain some time. I will duplicate this one. I will, let's see, remove the last bevel. So this one, whoop. I will remove the solidify control. Boom. It's not working. Yes, like that. And I will play with this one, just like that, to gain some times. 7, R, 7, let's see, D, up, just like that. I will go in edit mode and scale it a little, and maybe come here, like that, go in top view, I cannot see it sadly, scale it like that, and scale it a little like that, just move it here. So what I wanted to do is to come here, play with this one, boom, maybe decrease the number of segments on the bevels, so I will decrease it a lot, because I want to use subdivision surface on this one. Select the other one, and same do something like that. To have to try to have something homogenic, and that should work. What I will do is to apply with shift everything, boom, and I can let's see, change the auto smooth on this one, and weirdly I have this. So let's remove control this. So now what I will do is select, in fact I can remove this one, select this one, press R, just like that, and just move it here, to gain, as you can see, sometimes, to not have to do the work each time. Up, maybe scale this one, make this, it's not perfect, it's not really an issue. I can on this one, let's see, add a subdivision surface, and after what I will do is to add some loops, just like that. I can press R, and normally I have some options to use the event offset, it's not working, well, not a problem, select this, press GG, do the same here. So this is not really basic of Speedflow Basic, because you can make something really complicated with Speedflow. And this one, in fact, I will remove all of this up, B. But you can use all the techniques we learned previously, and you will have something perfect. So let's move it here. Okay. So we made this. This is almost correct. GG. Like that. I will do the same for this one, press Ctrl R, like that, and in fact what I will do is to select, I cannot select those two, just move it a little, hop, can do this, hop, let's try, so this is normal polygon modeling, nothing complicated, everybody can do it, hop. With this, that will be better, I think. Up. I don't want to add too many subdivisions, so you don't have. So just make something correct. Up. Try to have something uniform. Should be enough. Move this here. I will fix all of this after. As you can see, this one needs more subdivisions. And maybe I need to add more subdivisions, in fact, on this one. I mean, make something like that, and add some subdivisions. Up. Press GG. GG. Okay, so I can select this one, press GG, and press Ctrl B, like that. And one thing I can do is to move this one a little. Up. Like that. Same for this one, GG, that will give this. After you can use the sculpt tools. Let's use this one, let's show the wireframe, and let's remove the bevel, find the subdivision surface. And like that, you will be able, Shift F to decrease the power. I don't know why the power is at 1, it's really bad, bad default setting in my opinion. And I will do the same here. Here. You can show the wireframe to be sure. Like that. Hopla. Up. Need to select it. Like that. Be sure here too. It's not perfect. It's not really an issue on this one because it's not a perfect piece. It's not meant to be perfect, as you can see, I will after edit it a little, just like that, up. And I will add a loop here, and a loop here. And in fact, I will select all of this and just, let's see, make something like that. I needed this one to just make a retention of the point here, like that. And this one will move here. Press G. Same for this one, in fact. Control R, like that. Let's select this, this, and this. Hop là. Not you. You. No, not you. You. And make it like that. So just after move this up like that. So as you can see, up. Try to make something that will work. And you can smooth it a little if necessary. Up. And just like that, as you can see, that will work. I think I need to change the color of my wireframe. This is not really usable like that. Up. Try to fix it. Up, up, up. Let's remove the subsurf to be sure we have something that will work. As you can see here, this is not the case. We want something uniform, something clean. Up. And funny thing, this move on the sculpt mode is why I came to Blender. In fact, I used something to Maya, but it wasn't what I wanted. And playing with Blender, I found this one really useful, except for the one by default. I don't know why they did this. And let's see. Boom. We have this. Yes, seems correct. I can increase, in fact, this to make it and make something not too perfect. Up like that. I should add more, etc. But after I can, if I want, also. Directly, boom, boom, make some sculpt to add more details, but it's not the point right now. Okay, tata, maybe. Try to make something nice. Just like that. Okay, so I think it's not too bad. Boom. It's not perfect. Maybe I need to, maybe, let's edit it a little. Bam, bam, bam. Yep. I'm not really pleased with it right now. I think I need to move this one. Let's see, like that. And after, let's select this and this, activate the this one. And since I'm using a pen, up, I need to do this. Up, like that. Up. Yes, this is better. Even if it's not perfect. I can edit it after, it's not really an issue. Up. Press O. So, I will stop here, even if it's not perfect, because if I continue 3 hours like that, that will not be really interesting. So, I can maybe fix a little this. Up. Up, up. There is some difficulties to select, and the wireframe and the white on the white, it's not really fun. Up, up, up. So let's keep it like that and that should do the work. Okay. So we made this. So now what I will do is to save my scene. Save as. Up. Plus. Save. Let's continue. What I want is in fact to edit this one because it's not okay because the tube will come here. So I will hide this one and not you. In fact, I can hide those two. Boom. Okay. I can show this one and I want to edit this one. So let's activate the overlays. Come here. Select all of this. Just move it like that. After select this one and move it like that. Okay, so as you can see here, this is not correct. So let's edit the cube. Come here, select everything. Maybe scale it a little. Move it like that. And let's try to scale it in this. Yes, that will be better like that. Okay, so I will go in object mode. I will select this one, Shift S, cursor to selected, Shift Q, add a screw primitive, and let's move it here. I will press G. I will press, in fact, G, E, Z to contrain on the Z axis. Move it here. Press E. Like that, let's see if I don't, yes, it's correct. And let's move it here. Press E, like that. On this screw, it seems the normal are reverted, so just like that. I will now use the new tool, this move origin onto Blender 2.81, and I will press G, and I will snap directly here. So the origin will be there now. I can on this one add a mirror. I will press X to remove and add Z mirror, just like that. So just like that, if I want, I can edit this one. Press G. Let's see, like that. And press G. Let's see, like that. Because now if I add an array in Z1, boom, I will have this result. So as you can see, this is what I want. Let's remove the array. Place this one at the origin of this scene. You will see this is important. And now I will hide this one, show the top and the other one, and I will add a curve. I have this one selected, okay. I will come here, I will press Ctrl, and I will, on the tubify, I will draw my curve. Just like that. So as you can see, with this workflow, you can draw your object really fast. And I can edit now my curve. That means I will press G like that. Up. Move it. I think I will have to edit a little the object after. But right now, it's working. I don't have a bevel on this one, so I can edit my curve pretty easily. So this is nice. Up, I can try to make something that will work. Up, let's see. Up, come. And the last one. Let's make it like that. Up. So, in top view now, 7. Let's edit it a little. Press G. Select this one. I will place it here. So that means boom. And I think it's this one. No, this one. No, I want this one. 7 G like that. So just like that, I can move my object, edit it. Up. Pretty easily. Up. 7. Try to make something interesting. And let's see, press Control to have the last one. Okay, seems nice. Maybe not. Up. It's up to you to do what you want. After, you can also add some hooks on this one to be able to edit it on the fly if you want to animate it. And that will work. So, up like that. Let's see inside view. It's almost correct. Let's move this one. Let's make it flat. Press G. Up. It's this one that needs some work. Z-axis. Up. Okay, it's not perfect, but that should do the trick. Up. Okay. So, we have this. Yep-la. We will make the piece here. Here, maybe on this one. We will, in fact, edit it a little, select everything, and I can activate the curve here. Let's come here, and I will press GX like that to make it a little bigger. Okay, should be enough. So, I want a piece here, so I will press Shift-C, place the cursor at the center. I will press Shift-Q, add screw primitive. I will just come here. Oula, yeah, yes. As you can see, this is the origin, and you need to disable it, and this is pretty weird. What I can do on this one... I will just do this. I'm a warrior, so select... Hopla. I want this one, press G, press E, like that. We will edit it after. Press E, press G in Z, and youpla, press E, just like that. Press G. Let's see, yes, it seems to be like that. So on the screw, press R. After, I can add a bevel here, add a bevel here. Add a solidify, like that, up. Come back on the bevel, add a new one, like that. And I can edit this screw to add more subdivisions, let's see 48. So, I made this. On this one, I will use hit here to show you. I want to add end cap, so I will pick the object, and boom, I will have this result. So what I will do is to select everything, up. I will come here, select all of this, press G, here. I can, in fact, select all of this and press G to move it here, or I could use also yes, it's nice, a displace. Yes, should have worked with a displace too. And if I do this, I will just move it, let's see, I want to select those ones. Press G, just like that. Up. Maybe, edit this one, press G, and maybe this one too, like that, up, and that's it, I can hide this one, and my object is done, voila! Everything is correct. I will deselect it. We will see. As you can see, you have all the details. We have something pretty nice. Ah, I forgot one thing. Let's add a bevel on this one. But on this big object, that will be, that will take time. So, should have hide the other part. But when it's correct, let's see. Yes, it's nice. Oh, perfect. Ta-da! Select everything. And this is our object. And as you can see here, I have some weird things that mean I can increase the number of segments of my curve. Let's see, 64. Bam. I should have a better result here. And that's the case. So this is nice. This is my result. And in fact, I could add some parts here to attach it. Could be interesting to make it, in fact. This one will be pretty easy. That means I will create a plane. Alt G. I will just move it here. Scale it like that. Scale it like that. Up. Select this one, the face. Press X. Only face. And if I check now, I will have this. Okay. So what I will do is select everything. Up. I will add a bevel. Like that. On this one, I can, if I want, let's increase the number of segments, add a skin. That will give me this. And let's see, add another bevel. Like that. I can, if I want, go in edit mode, press Ctrl A to decrease the size of my object. Ctrl A, Z. It will not work. Ctrl A, Y to make this or to make this. Okay. Ctrl A, Y. Okay. So I will keep this one here. I will just move it. Let's see here. Maybe the last bevel is a little too small. I want something better like that. And let's move this object. I can, in fact, in this case, use the origin. Just move the origin here to cheat a little. Up, go here, press G, press R to make something like that. Up, and yes, just edit everything, scale it a little. It should do the work, and that's it. Bam! So, our object is correct. Everything is fine. And that your object is fully editable. That means absolutely everything is editable. The result is perfect. And with SpeedFlow, you can make a different version. You can make it. You can make this kind of asset, not only art surface, sci-fi, etc. Absolutely everything. So that's it. I hope you like this video. This is a SpeedFlow basics, and see you later on the next video. And blue thumbs in English, I don't know what it is. And abonne-toi. Bye bye. If you like this video, think about subscribing, give a like, and activate the bell so you don't miss the new videos. See you later.